John Ronald Reuel Tolkien was an impressive person, to say the least. He invented whole worlds, sort of deep lore and amazing characters, yet before he did any of that, he created his own languages. Tolkien loved creating his own languages, and even went on to say, "The invention of languages is the foundation. The stories were made rather to provide a world for the languages than the reverse." This of course led to Tolkien creating whole languages of words, and of course what we are more interested in, names. There are countless names we could talk about in Middle-earth, but for now, let's just stick to 9 names, those being the names of the Fellowship of the Ring. Now, the etymology of these names can be handled in 2 different ways, the in-lore way explaining what the names mean in the universe and languages of Middle-earth, and a more meta way, simply where Tolkien got the ideas for these words from real-world factors. We'll be using a mix of these 2 ways to help us understand just how Tolkien came up with these names. The first thing we need to figure out, however, is what language are these names even in? From a meta perspective, The Lord of the Rings is written in English by J.R.R. Tolkien, from ideas from his own head. Yet from an in-lore perspective, the stories of The Lord of the Rings and The Hobbit come from the Red Book of Westmarch, which was written in Restron, the common tongue of Middle-earth, by Bilbo and Frodo, which was then adapted into English by Tolkien from an old copy he had found. I guess to really understand The Lord of the Rings and Tolkien's Middle-earth writings as a whole, imagine it being a book of old Greek mythology written in ancient Greece, it being found and translated into English. But how did Tolkien even create these languages? Well, Tolkien was obsessed with languages. Ones that really stuck with him were old languages of the British Isle and Nordic origins. His languages were spliced from languages like Old English, Welsh, and Finnish. So let's start with Frodo Baggins, which is actually his name adapted into English from Hobbitish, which is a subdialect of the aforementioned Westron, which is Mara Labingi. Also, just a big apology about pronunciation in this video. Forvo is fantastic, but I don't seem to specialize in languages for Middle-earth. Mora probably means something along the lines of wise and experienced, coming from the Rohan language word more meaning experienced. From a meta out of lore perspective, the name Frodo could be derived from the Old English flod, meaning wise by experience. I'll be honest with you all though, I've always thought Frodo was a bit of a dweeb. Samwise Gamgee on the other hand, now he's the real hero. Much like Frodo, Samwise Gamgee is the English translation of his Hobbitish name, Banazir Gabalzi. Banazir coming from the Westron words ban meaning half and zir meaning wise. Yes, Sam's name pretty much means halfwit. Poor guy. Stepping out of the lore of the books, the surname Gamgee comes from the real-life source of Joseph Sampson Gamgee, who invented the surgical dressing Gamgee tissue. The name Gamgee alone became a colloquial term for cotton wool in Birmingham, where Tolkien grew up. Merodach Brandybuck and Peregrine Took are of course not their real names either. Merry's Hobbitish name is Calimac Brandagamba, which is really fun to say, and Pip's is Vlazanur Took. How in English Merodach's nickname is Merry, in Hobbitish his nickname is Cali from Calimac, which is thought to mean handsome and happy. The surname Brandagamba contains Brand, meaning borderlands, in reference to Buckland, the land area ruled by the Brandybucks being on the eastern edge of the Shire. Out of lore, Merodach means Great Lord in Welsh. Pip's name in and out of lore relates to travelling. The English translated name of Peregrine comes from the Latin word Peregrinus, meaning pilgrim, whereas his Hobbitish first name Vlazanur means stranger and foreigner. The surname of Took is a very old name and is of unknown meaning in Hobbitish. Out of lore, however, Took is a Welsh surname, referring to a type of sword. Okay, so that's more than enough concerning hobbits for now. Let's look into the men of the Fellowship. And by men, I don't mean the males of the Fellowship, as they were all men. I mean members of the Fellowship whose race were men. Aragorn's name is just Aragorn and wasn't something else translated into English. Aragorn is a Sindarin name, Sindarin being the most common elf language of the Third Age when Lord of the Rings takes place. It simply means revered king, with Aran meaning king and Gorn meaning revered. Yet when we first meet Aragorn, he goes by a much different name. Strider. This name was given to him by the people of Bree in reference to the long legs of the Rangers in comparison to their much shorter legs. Boromir's name comes from the 11th ruling steward of Gondor, who was also named Boromir. Like Aragorn, the name Boromir is not an English translation of a Westron name, but unlike Aragorn's name which comes only from Sindarin, Boromir's name is made up from words from the Cyrodiil language and the Quenyar language, Quenyar being another Elven language. Bora is Sindarin for steadfast, and Mir is Quenyar for jewel. Gimli's name comes not from the lore of Middle-earth, but from a completely different lore, Norse lore, with Tolkien stating in a draft of a letter that the name comes from the poetic Old Norse word gim, supposedly meaning fire. Tolkien had a huge fascination with Norse mythology. The poetic Edda is a collection of Old Norse poems, the first in the collection being called Völuspá. The name appears once in Völuspá and three times throughout the Edda. It's thought to mean one of the Gimel, Gimel being the legendary place of Norse mythology where the survivors of Ragnarok live. What's also interesting, going back to that Norse poem Völuspá, there's a section called the Catalogue of Dwarves that feature many names Tolkien would use in his tales, such as Durin, Folin, Biffer, Boffer, Bomber, and another name Tolkien didn't use for a dwarf, but it's one that we will look into later. Legolas means Greenleaf. In fact, at one point he is referred to as Legolas Greenleaf, with that being his second name, so his full name is kind of Greenleaf Greenleaf. His name consists of the Sindarin word leg, which is a very rare old term for green, and Golas, meaning a collection of leaves. Finally, we have Gandalf. As I said, from an out of lore perspective, Gandalf's name was with the rest of the dwarf names in the ancient Norse poems, but Gandalf is most definitely not a dwarf. So what is Gandalf? He is a Maia spirit, which is something we ought not to get into too much, but in layman terms, a kind of angel spirit thingy. It's confusing. But when he first became known to the people of Middle-earth, they called him Gandalf, which comes from an unknown source, meaning Elf of the Wand, due to his ability to use magic for a staff. Yet there are many other names for Gandalf. Olorin is his original name from the Undying Lands of Valinor and comes from the Quenyan Olos or Olor, meaning dream or vision. Mithrilandi is his Sindarin name, meaning Grey Pilgrim or Wanderer. And in the secret language of the dwarves, his name is Farkon, meaning Grey Man. I guess if you've spent so much time in the world and visited so many places with different languages, you would end up with a variety of names. But in his own words, Gandalf means one thing. Gandalf means me. A huge thank you needs to go out to the Tolkien Gateway. They didn't sponsor this video, but it wouldn't have been anywhere near as easy to create it without them. Otherwise, I would have had to read through appendices and letters and unfinished stories. To call Tolkien just a writer of fantasy books would be a huge understatement. Even just to say he created a whole world with deep lore doesn't do him justice. Popular culture has graced us with many fantasy worlds from Hogwarts to Westeros to get lost in, but not as many fantasy languages to get lost in. Now, not to throw shade at George R.R. Martin, but he has even said that he doesn't have Tolkien's gift for languages, and that he hasn't created any languages himself, but could only sketch in each of the chief tongues of his imaginary world in broad strokes, and give them each their own characteristic sounds and spellings, which is still very impressive, and Dothraki has since been made into a proper language thanks to the TV show. Tolkien, however, created it all. The world, the lore, the characters, the languages, an entire mythology as rich as a real world mythology created from one man's mind. It's incredible. This video was very different to my usual kind, so thank you for making it to the end. If you enjoyed it and want to see more unique videos like this one that won't rely on a high viewership to earn money, then why not support the Patreon? Just $2 a month will get your name with all these awesome people. Thank you.